Thank you for joining Roots Yoga today. We are going to be working on some funky flows for our yoga class today. And you will need a tennis ball if you have it and a yoga block. If you don't, I'll give you some modifications along the way so that you can still join us in class today. So let's get started standing up at the top of our mat. And if you have that tennis ball, let's put it under the right toe mound, big toe mound. If you don't, it's okay to just do this activity without the ball. So we're going to start by lifting and spreading all five toes. So that ball is underneath the base of the big toe mound. See if you can lift the big toe and the other four toes and spread them like you're spreading your fingers. And then see if you can curl your toes into the ball or into the ground. And then see if you can lift and spread the toes again. And curl. And one more time, lift and spread, and curl. Now, see if you can isolate and just lift the big toe mound, the big toe, away from the ball or away from the floor. That's a little trickier. Good job. And then place that big toe down, and can you lift the other four toes up? Great job. Just trying to isolate some of those toe extensor muscles. Let's try that one more time. Lift the big toe up, place it down, and then lift the other four toes and place it down. Great job. If you have a ball, we're going to work on rolling that ball vigorously from the big toe mound, forefoot area to the heel, back and forth, back and forth. If you don't, I'm going to have you work on coming forward on your toes and then rocking back on your heel, allowing that plantar fascia on the bottom of your foot to stretch out. If you have that ball, roll vigorously down the middle of the foot and then make sure you also get the inner and outer arch of the foot. So taking that ball to the inside and the outside. And this is a great way to get our feet ready for a standing yoga practice. Also, if you have any issues with plantar fasciitis, this is a great series to do to stretch the bottom of our feet and open up that plantar fascia. So let's go ahead and remove the ball from that right foot. Stand on that right foot. See if it feels a little more open, a little more alive, a little looser perhaps. And then we're going to take that ball over to the left foot. Starting with lifting and spreading all five toes, and then curling around that ball. Lift and spread again, and curl. One more time, lift and spread, and curl. Now see if you can isolate just the big toe on that side, lifting it up, and then placing it down. See if you can lift the four toes and release. One more time, lifting just the big toe and releasing down, and then the other four toes. Great job. We'll begin that plantar fascia release by rolling the ball back and forth vigorously from the toe mounds to the heel, and then rolling on the inside of the foot and the outside. Great job. And then release that foot. You can move the ball off the mat and then stand tall and see how that feels. See if you feel a little looser in your feet, a little more ready to start your practice today. So we're going to begin in standing with our first flow. Standing in our mountain pose, feet close together, arms down by our sides, we'll begin by inhaling the arms overhead and exhaling the hands to heart center. Repeating that two more times. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, release to heart center. One more time. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Beautiful job. This time we're going to add a forward fold. Inhaling the arms overhead. Exhale, swan dive, forward fold towards the floor. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, hands to heart center. Let's try that two more times. Just beginning to warm up our bodies. Inhale, exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep the arms back up. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Beautiful. One more time. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, arms reach overhead. Exhale, hands come to heart center. So we're going to play with this inhale and exhale with our arms, but add a little bit of a chair pose here. So inhaling the arms overhead, exhale, we're going to sink down into chair pose. Good job. And then inhale as we grow long, straighten the legs, arms come back to heart center. Repeating that two more times. Inhale, arms overhead, exhale, sinking down into your chair pose. Thinking about tucking that tailbone down, drawing the navel up and in. Good. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, hands come back down to heart center. One more time. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, sink back into your chair. Check in with that tailbone, tuck it under, draw the navel to the spine. Inhale, straighten the legs. Exhale, hands to heart center. Beautiful. So we're going to continue with our chair pose, and this time add a little bit of a twist. Inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, sink down into our chair pose. This time we're going to take our hands to heart center. Our left elbow is going to come to the outer right knee as we begin to twist. Taking a breath here. Inhale, back to center. Unwind that twist, and then straighten the legs, inhale the arms overhead, exhale, back to center. And now we'll go towards your left. Inhale, arms overhead, exhale, sink back down into your chair pose, hands come to heart center, right elbow to the outer left knee, as we begin to open the spine, open the chest. Slowly unwind the twist back to center. Inhale, grow tall, straighten the legs. Exhale, hands to heart center. Beautiful job. So we're going to do that twist again with a slight variation. Are you guys beginning to feel your legs warming up a little bit? I know I am. So let's inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, sink back into our chair pose. Hands come to heart center again. We're going to twist to the right, left elbow to outer right knee. This time you have the option to stay here or open the arms nice and wide. One arm reaching towards the ceiling, one to the floor. Breathing here. Bring the hands back to prayer position. Unwind the twist. Inhale, grow tall as you reach your arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Great job. We're going to go to the other side. Inhale overhead. Exhale, sink into chair. Hands come to heart center. Twisting to your left. Option to keep the hands here in prayer position or to open one arm reaching to the ceiling and one arm reaching to the floor. Breathing here. Bringing those hands back to prayer. Unwind the twist. Inhale, straighten the legs. Exhale, hands to heart center. Great job. If you have a yoga block, let's put it in front for our next series with our chair pose. Inhaling, arms overhead. Exhale, sinking back down into our chair. Hands come to heart center. This time, we're going to reach for the block in front of us. And we're going to keep that left knee bent as the right leg straightens. From here, that right arm is going to sweep up towards the ceiling. Beginning to open the chest and feel some opening across the spine, creating some mobility. And exhale, release that arm down. This time we're going to bend the right knee, sweep that left arm up. Exhale, release. Let's do that one more time each side. Bending the left knee, right arm reaches towards the ceiling. And release. Right knee bends, left arm reaches towards the ceiling. And releasing back down. From here, we'll inhale as we straighten our legs, reach to the ceiling. Exhale, hands to heart center. Beautiful job. And that completes our first flow today. So let's come down to our mats to begin our second flow. Making sure that we have a block ready, we're going to begin in a tabletop position. And we're going to move our right foot forward between our hands into a low lunge. From here, we're going to shift that weight forward. Beginning to open up that left hip flexor, that left groin. If you have your block and want a little extra height, you can always use your block to help you with these lunges. Otherwise, fingertips can reach to the floor. From here, we're going to place our hands on the mat, lift our back toes, and step that front foot back into a downward facing dog. Taking a breath or two here as we begin to open our body in downward facing dog. Look between the hands and step that right foot back to the top of the mat. From here, we can drop that knee down into our low lunge, or we can play with a high lunge, balancing as we come up and perhaps lifting the arms overhead. Great job. Exhale, hands come back down to the floor. Step that front leg back into our downward facing dog. Looking between the hands, step that right leg forward. We're going to spin the back heel down, coming up into our Warrior Two pose. Front knee is bent and our gaze is out over the front hand. One breath here. Windmilling our arms back down to the mat and stepping back down into our downward facing dog. Taking one or two breaths here in our down dog. Stepping that right leg forward. This time we're going to move our hands on the inside of that right leg and drop down on the back knee, coming into our lizard pose. So if you have your block, you might want to use it to come down, elbows to the block. Hands can come to the mat, elbows to the floor, elbows to the block, whatever you need today to feel that opening in the front hip and the back groin. And breathing here. And then slowly come all the way up on your hands. Slightly move that block to the side. And we're going to come into a forearm plank. So that top leg is going to come back. And we're going to come down on our forearms. And then lifting the heels up, I'm going to do a plank here for 5 deep breaths. Holding and breathing. Good job. Draw that navel to the spine, shoulder blades down the back body. And then release those knees down. Hands come to the mat. Coming into a left side sit. So the left leg is going to be on the bottom, and the right leg is going to cross over the top. Sitting up nice and tall, Right hand reaches behind, left arm reaches up. Elbow, left elbow comes to the right knee as we begin to twist to the right. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, twist. Inhale, create length. Exhale, twist a little deeper. And then slowly unwind that twist, coming back to center. From here, we're going to move into Gomukhasana legs. So that top right leg is going to try to stack on top of the bottom left leg. If you have a little space between your knees, you can always take a blanket, a block, a pillow to provide a little extra support if you need it. So from here, sitting up nice and tall, this may be a really great stretch already for both hips. If you feel like you need a little bit more, you can fingertip walk the hands forward and feel a little deeper opening. Maybe even putting your block in front and allowing the elbows to come down to the block and enjoying that opening in the outer hips. And then walking those hands back, we're gonna carefully unwind that twist. And the left leg is going to shoot back as the right leg comes across, coming into our pigeon pose. Setting up for pigeon, our arms are reaching down towards the mat, nice straight elbows as we open across the chest, broaden through the collarbones, lift the head. And then if we would like to, we're going to fold forward, coming down into our pigeon pose. Really feeling that opening all across the right outer hip. Breathing into that space, allowing it to open and release. Two more breaths here. And then slowly walking the hands back to the body. We're going to shift our weight towards that right side and draw our left leg around, coming into Baddha Konasana. So soles of the feet together, knees are out wide, hands come underneath the feet to allow our bodies to sit up nice and tall and create opening across the collarbones and across the front of the chest. Taking a few deep breaths here, feeling the opening in the inner groin, and the length created in the spine. Great job. So taking our block in front of us, we're gonna carefully use our hands to bring our knees together. Hands come behind the body, and we're gonna come up into a little bit of a squat. This is preparation for frog pose. So our heels are together, our feet are out, and our knees are out to the side. Hands come between the legs. If you have a block, it might be helpful. As we push down into the block, we're gonna lift our body up and our legs straighten. And then inhale, release. Exhale, straighten. Good job. Inhale, release. Exhale, straighten. One more time. Inhale, release. Exhale, straighten. Great job. Coming all the way back down. We'll take our block to the side and come back into our tabletop position and then lifting our hips skyward, coming back into downward facing dog. While you're here, pedal the feet out, back and forth. Checking in with that right side of your body. How does it feel compared to the left? And then looking between the hands, step that left foot between the hands and drop that back knee down, coming in to our low lunge on the second side. Inhale the arms up overhead, coming into our low lunge, shifting that weight forward, feeling the opening all across the right inner groin. And then exhale, release the hands to the mat. Step that front leg back into your downward facing dog. Taking a breath or two here in down dog. Looking between the hands, we're stepping that left leg back in between the hands. Option to drop the knees and work with your low lunge position, or to lift the back toes, come up into a high lunge, working a little bit of balance, and then inhale the arms overhead. Beautiful. Exhale, hands come back to the mat. Step that front leg back into our downward facing dog. Looking between the hands, set the left leg forward. Spin the back heel down. Windmill the arms up into our warrior two position. Nice strong warrior position. Exhale. Windmill the arms back down, coming into your downward facing dog. From here, we're stepping that left foot forward again. Drop the back knee and let's bring the hands inside that front foot. Coming into our lizard pose. So playing with if this position with extended elbows is enough of a stretch, or if you'd like to come down on your forearms on the mat, or perhaps use a block to come down to you. Feeling that opening all across the front outer hip and the inner groin on the back leg. Holding and breathing. One more breath here. Slowly releasing the pose. We can slide our prop to the front of our mat. And we'll take that back foot, or the front foot back, coming into our forearm plank. So coming down on our forearms, we're going to lift our hips, draw the shoulder blades down the back body, draw the navel to the spine, and holding for 5 deep breaths. If your body starts to shake a little bit, embrace that shake. And then knees come back down to the mat. Coming into a right side sit. So this time our right leg will be on the ground, left leg crosses. Sitting up nice and tall, left arm reaches behind, right arm reaches to the ceiling. That right elbow is coming to the left knee as we begin to twist. Inhale, create length. Exhale, twist. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, twist a little deeper. And then gently unwind that twist, working into our Gomukhasana legs, where we're going to stack our knees on top of each other. Again, if you feel like you need a little support, if there's some space between your knees, you can add a block, a blanket, or a pillow. Sitting up nice and tall, feeling that stretch in the outer left hip, and playing with if this is a good position for you to stay in for the stretch, or if you would like to go a little deeper, you can walk the hands forward any amount, maybe coming down to a block on your forearms, and breathing into that opening that you're feeling all across that outer left hip. One more breath here. Slowly walk your hands back towards your body. We can take our prop to the side. And we're going to undo our cross position and take our right leg back, left leg forward, coming into our pigeon pose. So beginning in an extended pigeon pose, maybe even coming up onto your fingertips, opening across the front of the chest, drawing the shoulder blades down. And then if you would like to, we can take this pigeon down towards the mat, allowing the hands to come down, maybe the head. head rests on the forearms. Really feeling that opening all across the left outer hip. One more breath here. And then walking those hands back towards your body. We're going to shift our weight towards that left side. Draw the right knee forward. Coming into Baddha Konasana. Soles of the feet together. Hands come underneath the feet. Sitting up nice and tall. Create length in your spine as you open across the collarbones, the front of the body. One more breath. And then using our hands, we'll bring our knees together. Hands come behind us as we shift forward for our frog pose. Bringing that block back in front of us. If the heels can touch, that's great. If you need a little more space, you can spread your feet apart just a little bit as well. Inhale as we lift up and then release. Let's try that two more times. Inhale as we stand up. Exhale to release. Two more times. And after the last one, let's place our block to the side. Step our feet back. Walk our feet all the way back to our final downward facing dog. Checking in with our body to see how we feel. Right side compared to left. And if we feel a little more open through our shoulders, our spine, and our hips. And then dropping our knees to our mat, we're going to come down for our final series on our back bodies. So I'm going to move my mat just a little bit so you can see me a little better. Coming all the way down onto our back bodies, keeping our knees bent, we're going to come into a little gentle bridge. As we lift our hips up, I want you to lift your arms overhead. And then exhale, release. Let's try that two more times. Gently lift the hips up. And inhale. As you lift your arms overhead. And then release. One more time. Inhale as we lift. Exhale as we lower. Keeping the knees bent, inhaling the left arm up overhead as we turn our head to the right. And then releasing on an exhale. Inhale the right arm up as we turn our head to the left. Alternating back and forth. Releasing any tension in the shoulder and the neck. One more time, either direction. And then coming back to center. Draw the knees in towards the chest and just gently rock back and forth. Maybe doing a few circles to release any remaining tension that you may have in the low back or the sacrum. And then straightening those legs out, coming into our final resting pose, our Shavasana, allowing the legs and the arms to open and release. Slowing the breath, slowing the mind, and allowing for complete surrender. While you're resting in Shavasana, I wanted to share a yogic thought with you. April 18th, we begin again every day. Living your yoga. Every day you are a beginning yoga student. Begin again right now. I invite you to remain in Shavasana for as long as you like. Thank you so much for joining us today. I hope you feel a little more grounded after your session with Roots Yoga. Namaste.